Would you like an incinerator? Hunting shotgun. Ooh. Hello. Love that as well. Smith & Wesson Model 10. Another one. Over encumbered again, I know. Well, I haven't got any ammo for it, but I can repair it up, I suppose. Oh. Inventory. Where is the thing for inventory? There it is. Oh, I was hoping that would make him come over here, but fine.
Motherfucker.
Have an incinerator. Why not? What could possibly go wrong? Where's the flame of fuel? There it is. Enjoy. I immediately regret this decision. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout New Vegas, where I'm holding my new favorite gun.
Motherfucker?
And motherfucker's holding his new favorite gun. And unfortunately, I'm really still not sure how I feel about that, but you're not compensating with something, are you? We'll see how we get on. If you set me on fire, I'm taking your new toy away. I'm confiscating it. Do you hear me? Right. You've had your warning. In the meantime, we've killed a lot of powder gangers. Or convicts, as the game seems to be referring to them. But they are powder gangers, nevertheless. Ooh. Oh, yes, and I got my other new gun. This little dainty little Colt 18-something-something. Which is, you know, a bit petite. And frankly, a little ladylike for my tastes, but, you can't argue with those damage numbers, can you, really? It's very shiny as well. ...28 damage, and it's not even fully repaired.
Motherfucker.
Yes, you sneak with your incinerator. I suppose the one silver lining is that you don't have a terrific amount of ammunition for it, so... Hello. Deputy Beagle, I assume.
I don't suppose you came here to rescue me. I'd cross my fingers, but my hands are numb.
You must be Deputy Beagle.
Why, yes I am. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm in a bit of a predicament here. I'd be most appreciative if you'd set me free.
I hear you may have information on some cons that came through here with a guy in a checkered suit. A chap in a checkered suit, rather.
Indeed I do, good sir. And I would be thrilled to share that information with you as soon as I am released from captivity.
Alright, I'll set you free. He's being very polite, so, you know.
Oh, that's just marvelous. I think I'll be making my way outside now. The air is a little close in here.
Hold on there, you little... If you try to run away instead of fighting at my side, I shall shoot you myself.
Oh, why, of course. I'd never let you fight my kidnappers with my help, but without it. You lead the way.
There are two things in this world I cannot abide. They are cannibals and deserters. So you stay close. And do try not to get killed, because I need your information. Although, that said, he was apparently taking notes, so perhaps he is a little more expendable than I originally thought. That's an encouraging thought. Whiskey. No, scotch. Damn and blast it. Why is scotch so damn rare, anyway? Right, come on, you two. I don't suppose you've got a gun, have you?
If we were to miss a convict or two in here, who'd know the difference?
Indeed. Beagle, take a weapon.
I just hope I won't have to use it.
How about a really No, actually, that's quite valuable. perhaps not. What can we give you? Oh, I want the ammunition for that, so... Oh, you've got a 9mm pistol. You'd be fine. Deputy Beagle's journal. Let's get going.
And depart we will.
I'll read that later. I could just take it off him, I suppose, and read it now, but... It doesn't make much sense from a story perspective, does it? Stealth! Stealth. Learn how to do... Oh... Never mind. Never mind. Just getting through doors in one piece would, be a step in the right direction. Locked. Easy. Go. Oh. Oh, hello. What about, oh, what's this? Mentats, bubble gun, no thank you. No, I think we'll be fine without that as well. Aha, now then. We still need to get that safe with blueprints in it, don't we? So, onwards and upwards, chaps! Look at Beagle taking up the six they're carrying at the back. Although I'm not in much of a position to criticize people for hiding at the back, am I? Okay.
Hey!
Oh, of course his first shot hits me straight in the head, of course! What is it with people shooting me in the head? Have I got a magnet lodged in there or something? Ouch. You know what, yeah, I'm gonna have to use a doctor's bag for this, because there's no doctors anywhere nearby here, and I've just used two doctor's bags, because I'm an idiot. Oh. I'm sorry, but I won't let that stand. You know, getting the shot in the head, totally fine. No need to reload for that, but wasting a doctor's bag, hell yes, I'm reloading. Oh, seriously, what is it with my head and bullets? Now Beagle's dead. Did you kill Beagle with that thing? We're over here, you... Okay, I take it back. Yes, you... You know, do your thing. This is not half a bad pistol, is it? And now I've got to use two bloody doctor's bags anyway. Well, I guess that's what I... That's what I get for save scumming, I suppose. Fair enough. Right, I need to really, really not... Nothing personal, Beagle, but I think I need your armor. Where's my... There we are. There we go. Begin to think maybe wearing a helmet would be a good idea, no matter how ridiculous it looks. Pistol's not bad, though. Provided I can actually hit anyone with it, it seems to do the job. Listen to Beagle's journal. Oh, well. I shall do that in a moment. Oh, everyone's packing these guns, isn't they? Aren't they? They're quite popular, it would seem. Which is probably bad news for me, because it does quite a bit of damage. Oak adventure outfit, no, rubbish. GSH18, I've already got one of those, don't I? I suppose I could repair it. Rattan cowboy hat. Why not? Try it on. feel like I need at least some damage resistance on my head at the moment. Because it might explain why it seems to be uncannily attractive to enemies' bullets. That and the fact that I'm crouching half the time, which puts me at sort of hip-shooting level for anyone that happens to be shooting in my direction, so... Okay. Oh yeah, mine's almost full condition. Not bad. Still not as good as this, though. I think the magazine capacity might be a bit better, though. Come on, you. You know what? As much as I like this pistol, I'm thinking maybe this is a better bet right now. Oh, hang on a minute. He uses 12 gauge, not 20 gauge. Ah, that's annoying. That's actually very annoying. Oh, where's my shotgun then? There you are. Okay. Anything in here? No, just empty whiskey bottles. Wonderful. And a light switch that doesn't work. I'm looking for medical kits at this point. I desperately, desperately need doctor's bags. Or Hydra, frankly. At this point, I'd stoop to using Hydra. Did I loot you? Yeah, I think I did. Oof. Don't do that! You nearly gave me a heart attack for flipping hell's sake.
Motherfucker.
Suitcase, dresser, ooh. Pre-war money, it's worth something to someone. God knows why. I mean, in theory, you'd think it'd be the most useless flipping item you could possibly come across out here in the wasteland, pre-war money. Because there's loads of it, and it's not used for anything anymore, so... I don't know. I mean, we have NTR dollars, we have Legion denarii. Maybe there's someone out there that does still use pre-war dollars. Gun cabinet, hello. 22 revolver. Yeah, I'll take it, but... Ransom note. Hello? Mr. Peterson, if you want to see your wife alive again, bring the cash in small unmarked bills to the Bison Steve on Tuesday. Deputy Beagle's journal.
This is most unusual. The Powder Gangers have visitors today. I guess there's a first for everything. Now those tough-looking fellows must be great cons. I recognize those funny helmets and leather vests from stories I've heard. So what are they doing with that dapper gentleman who wears a checked suit? I wouldn't mind a suit like that. They're talking about heading south toward Nipton, then west to Novak where they'll meet up with someone. I guess I could track them if I needed to, but the town of Prim needs me here to serve and protect. Oh my, I think I've been spotted.
Oh dear. Deputy Beagle, old chap, I have a feeling you probably won't be missed. What has a steam gauge or something in a tire iron doing in there? It clearly says fire hose real. Fire hose reel. Do you not know what a fire hose reel is? I can't think of it, neither do I. No, moving on. Does this place have an upstairs? Or are we in the upstairs? Upstairs of the upstairs, I mean. You know what, this is a bit more convenient right now. Okay, we've got a dead person. Excellent. One more to add to the collection. Some psycho. Suitcase for the jet. Some more pre-war money. A dead fellow in a bathtub? Wow, my god. Oh, that's a little odd, isn't it? Oh, I forgot to install that little patch, didn't I, for Ojo Bueno's thing, because now he's got a mutated rib cage which consists of solid plates of bone. Never mind, I'll fix that later. Switchblade, medics, psycho. I never remember to use medics, really. I should probably just sell a lot of it. Did I check for a medical kit in here? Ah, right, yes, we need to go up here. Anything back there? Nope. A large scorched book. Cigarettes. An empty desk. I have a sneaking suspicion everybody up here is dead, but you never know. Ooh, hello. More guns and ammo. Excellent. I'm practically carting around an entire armory with me right now, but the more the merrier. Keep the silence 22, actually. You never know when that might come in handy. Take that little subsonic 22. I'm sure there'll be some people chuckling who know what on earth I'm talking about. The rest of you don't pay any attention. More pre-war money, I guess. Alright, I'm not getting through there. I think we're just about done here, to be honest. Yes, we are in fact completely and utterly done here. Although, hello. Oh, I'd like to get through there. Can I get through there? Probably not. Okay. God, I thought I was stuck there for a second. Never mind. Right. Still haven't found a safe, have we? With blueprints in it. It sounds like Bert's stuck somewhere, but I'm sure he'll sort that out one way or another. Yeah, we're missing... Hello. Must have missed you. Merc Troublemaker outfit and metal armor. Think not. Yes, come on, safe. Safe. Door to Prim. No, don't want to go out there. Already been in there. Starting to get a bit lost here now, actually. This way. Why does my flashlight look so yellow, anyway? So I'm a little curious about that. And this is... Oh, it's a elevator. Which is broken. Oh, hello. Aha! Oh, a doctor's bag. Thank the heavens. Sensor module. I only need like a few more of those now, I think. I would like to repair that robot. In fact, it might almost be... What on earth? I give up. I really do. I'm not even going to question it anymore. Might be worth going back to Good Springs to pick up some sensor modules, actually, because I'd quite like to repair that robot. Bison Steve Blueprints. Hooray. Right then. I think we're done here. Yep, we're pretty definitely done here. I mean, did I loot everybody in here? I think I may have forgotten to do that. I got caught up in the whole intro thing. Because I'm pretty sure there were dead chaps over. Yep. Ah, 38 special rounds. Excellent. And stim packs and all sorts. Maybe I can make some 12 gauge rounds. I break down the 20 gauges and make some 12 gauges. And but then again, my hunting shotgun's in really terrible condition, so switching to it's probably not the best idea ever, but it is, in my honest opinion, a better shotgun. I can't help it. I like pump action shotguns. I do. I like them more than lever action ones. Personal preference and all that. I know what you like, clearly, because you can't stop putting it away and getting it back out again. Okay, yeah, you don't seem to want to actually put it away, do you? You just sort of cart it around everywhere with it attached to your arm. It does look a bit odd, but I'm going to be honest.
Motherfucker.
Just switch to your hammer for now. You don't need to go setting anyone on fire just yet.
Motherfuck.
Out of curiosity. Oh.
Motherfuck.
Well, I didn't mean you could never use it. Evidently he's gone off the idea. Whatever. Let's go. Spent more than enough time in this dank, rather horrible place. What's the time? 7 a.m. My god, man, we haven't had any sleep. Oh, hello. What's this? Locked hard. Terminal locked easy. Science skill 25 is required, eh? Well, I might have something to say about that. Science skill of 25 or a copy of Programmer's Digest. Here we go. Wasting. 2 of 7. Won't be ING then. Station... Could be... Could maybe, possibly, maybe be? 2 of 7. Bollocks. Brackets time. Again, I'm probably missing a bunch. Almost certainly missing a bunch. Can you replenish my allowance by any chance? Really, really like that, actually. There we go. Oh yes, remove the one I've already picked. Thanks. Stupid computer. Where? Come on! There's gotta be more than that. Gotta be, surely. Alright, well, wasting was 207, station was 207. So it was obviously the same two. And T. So T something, N something, something. Writing? No. Cutting? No, it can't be an ING. So, English? No. Cantina. Damn it! Sure I had that. It's got to be the TI, then. That's the common theme with all of them. Any time. Oh, had to be that, right. That was a bit of a gamble with only one attempt left, but... Disengage lock. Marvellous! So what have we got to show for ourselves? For our efforts here. A lunchbox. Some bubble gum. Some medics. Pistol. Yeah, I'm getting tired. Red axe. Vodka, iguana bits, junk food. Blah. First aid box. And a fucking safe. Ugh. I suppose there's a maintenance key. No, of course not. Well, there's no getting into that. There really is no getting into that. Not even with a magazine, I don't think. I'd need 50 to get into that. And a magazine only adds 10, so... Oh well. Probably wasn't anything that good anyway. Good morning, Prim. God, it's making me want to yawn just thinking about how little sleep David Crumpington's had. Ugh. Steve, really? Bit of a nav mesh issue here, I think.
Howdy.
Madam, howdy.
Before the Powder Gangers came to town, Johnson Nash ran the local store in the Mojave Express station.
Right, Steve.
From the look on your face, I'd say you got something for me. Am I right?
Yes, I found your blueprints, and the place is all clear.
Great job, partner. These prints give me a good idea how much more stuff we need. It looks like we should be able to salvage enough material from around the hotel to get the basic stuff done. Won't be much, just walls and a floor, but it's a start. Some of the town folks are itching to get to work, but they won't hit a lick until we get some law in this town. The sooner we get a new sheriff, the sooner we can get to cracking. Think you can help?
Oh, well, do you have any suggestions?
You might want to check with old man Nash, see what he says. I hear tell that old robot could be reprogrammed for the job, but I wouldn't know how to go about it. I recollect seeing some old parts lying about up in the Bison. Take a look around, maybe you'll find something that'll help. Anyway, come see me again after we get a new lawman. I'll fill you in on all the details you want to know. In the meantime, I'll be sorting through Granny's stuff to see what else I can find.
Right. Well, I know bringing law and order to the wasteland is what I do, but... I prefer to bring law and order to the wasteland after a good night's sleep.
Move along, please.
You have no idea how close I am to blowing you to bits.
Move along, please.
Be nice. Let's remember who we are and where we are. Apparently there's
Hello
a queue
there.
For the...
It's
oh.
good to see a friendly face. I almost took you for a raider, I did. Name's Malcolm. Malcolm Holmes. Don't suppose you'd care to trade. I'm missing a few essentials and... screw this. Lying just ain't in my nature. I'll tell it to you straight. I've been following you for a good bit now.
I feel slightly insulted at the notion that I look like a raider, but why are you following me?
It started off innocently enough. I was traveling, as I often do, and happened to observe you picking up one of those blue star caps. You didn't show any reaction to it, so I figured you didn't know what you'd gotten your hands on.
Well, why didn't you say anything then and there, you fool?
I had to make sure of your disposition. There's a lot of jumpy folks out there that'll shoot a man as soon as talk to him. Now that we're conversing, though, I can tell you what I know about those caps. There's an old wasteland legend that says somewhere out there is a fabulous treasure from before the war. Those caps with the blue star on them, the tale goes, are the key to that treasure. They're called Sunset Sarsaparilla Stars.
So, what kind of treasure are we talking about?
No one knows. Money, weapons, water... It is, or maybe was, something of value, and that's enough to get people motivated.
So, you collect these caps too, huh?
Nah, I gave it up years ago. Too dangerous. And even if I did still collect them, I'd tell you the same. There's people out there so mad with the idea of treasure that they'll attack strangers just on the suspicion that they have some of those caps.
Where can I find more of these caps?
All over the place. The easiest place to find them is unopened bottles of Sunset Sarsaparilla. You'd think they'd all have been picked clean by now, but somehow, new bottles keep appearing in the machines. Some say it's old Festus that does it, hoping someone will finally collect enough caps to earn the treasure. Other than bottles, you'll just have to scavenge. You can find caps in the unlikeliest of places, and Blue Star caps are no exception.
You mentioned someone named Festus. Who's that?
It's said that the treasure is guarded by a man named Festus, and he's the one who asked for the Blue Star caps. It's also said he's been around since the war, standing a lonely vigil, waiting for someone to come and take the treasure off his hands. That'll make him pretty damn old, but I've met a few people in my travels who claim they actually met him, and they weren't the lying type either.
Maybe he's a ghoul. Thanks for the info then, I'll be going now.
No problem. If you do end up trying to collect more stars, watch out for a man named Alan Marks. He's killed several people for their stars already.
Right then. Well, today is getting stranger and stranger by the minute. Yeah, we're getting tired. I suppose we've got coffee around here somewhere. Maybe a storm chaser. No. Atomic cocktail, perhaps? Oh, get out of my way. Don't have the energy for dealing with you.
Howdy.
It occurs to me I don't even have a bedroll or anything like that, so God knows what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to go all the way back to Good Springs. We're going to have to go all the way back to Good Springs. Ugh. Right, alright. Steve. No, not Steve. Where's the other fellow? Johnson Nash, was it?
Howdy.
Nope, not you.
Howdy. Howdy.
He was here a second ago. I saw him at one of the slot machines. I'll be damned. He's just...
Howdy.
Up and left. Oh, no, there he is.
Hey, youngster. Still hanging about Prim, huh?
Your deputy died in the Bison Steve, I'm afraid.
Well, I guess you're gonna have to find us a new lawman. I suggest talking to those NCR troopers across the bridge. I also overheard the Potter gangsters talking about some ex-sheriff on lockdown there.
You think I'm going to go and get a powder gang and take charge of this place? You've got another thing coming, old chap. Not on your life. What about Prim Slim? Could he beat you? Oh, good God, no. I wouldn't inflict that on my worst enemies. See you later.
Bye.
Okay, then. I have a sensor module. What did I need to repair that robot with? Let's see what the radio's got to say while we're here. Nothing other than music. Fine. I don't think I'm going to find out other than by looking at the robot again. Fine. Fine. I'll just have to make a note of it or something. Two sensor modules. Damn it, I've only got one. That's unfortunate. Oh well. Oh. Daniel Wyand. Mojave Express delivery order 4 of 6. So this is one of the other ones for that job I went on. He looks like he didn't fare much better than me. But he fared a good deal worse. He's probably not going to wake up from that. Data, misc, Instructions: deliver the package at the north entrance of the Vegas Strip by way of Freeside. Da di da di da da. Same as mine. 250 caps. The package contains two oversized dice composed of fuzzy material. Fuzzy dice, then. Good God. Is that technically two people in there? I see two heads. Good God. You really know how to ruin a chap's day, don't you? Well, I suppose there's nothing else to do now other than head all the way back to Good Springs. Is there? Well, we can go talk to these NCR fellows across the road, but yes, we need to go back to Good Springs. Frankly, I need to see the doctor. I need to go see Doc Mitchell and possibly buy some more things off him. I don't know. Doctor's bags, mostly. Definitely need some doctor's bags. And I could do with them just sort of treating my wounds, really. My limbs are in a bit of a shoddy state. Right. Lieutenant Hayes.
Yeah?
Prim is in dire need of some real law.
We know Prim is a great strategic point, and we aren't blind to the needs of the town, but we're barely holding our own against the powder gangers. We don't have the guns or the personnel needed to carry out our mission, much less take on defending this town as well.
Well, what do you need to take over protecting the town?
What we need more than anything is bodies. If we had just one more squad, we could easily install a sheriff.
You mean live bodies, right? I was going to say, there's more than a few over there you could use.
If you'd like to see the NCR include protection of Prim and its duties, then you'll have to get some more troops up here. Knight at Mojave Outpost may be able to help.
Okay.
Sir.
More errands to run. Lovely.
Hey.
Why is it whenever I come out of that tent, the weather just gets worse? Oh, good heavens, you know the other thing we came here for was we came to see Mr. Randall and associates, didn't we? I'm not sure I've got the energy for that now. You know, we need to make a good first impression. I'm not going to be able to do that after about 24 hours without sleep, am I? I think we'll have to leave that for another time. Right now, I just want to get back to Good Springs and back to my bed. My nice fixed-up schoolhouse without any electricity, but we're working on that, at least. We're working on it, aren't we? But we've got a long way to go before we get to Helios 1, that's for sure. Your favourite weapon! Well, it was your favourite weapon. That's where your preferences change with the tides, don't they, really? Well, it's going to be a bit of a walk, but no real alternative. At last, home sweet home. Oh, it's good to see you again. Oh, well then. I am going to go and sleep for an entire day. Because yes, as you can see, we are rather bloody tired. And I think once that's done, I will also go around and do some selling of items and some repairing and some ammo making and all that sort of rubbish that you don't really need to see on screen, and I will be back later. And I have returned with a bit of a status update. Everything has been sorted. I'm about 2,000 caps richer. All my parts and things have been stored, I've ditched a bunch of guns that I wasn't using, and I have all the things I require to fix the iBot. So, we're going back to Prim. My loadout's changed a bit as well, because, I mean, let's face it, I was, you know, I was carrying far too many guns, which is more than I could possibly need. So, I'm now equipped with this impronounceable piece of whatever it is. I'm just going to call it, I don't know what I'm going to call it, it's just my little pistol. I got this. I've got the Colt. I've got the trusty Lee Enfield. And I've got the lever action shotgun. And that is it. Oh, and some boxing tape, I think, unless I put that away. Anyway, I figure this is a decent enough loadout. There's, I've got a shit ton of ammo for this thing. I've even got some hollow point ammo, I think, for it, or whatever it is. So this, I figure, is quite good for using on things like geckos and other little critters like that. I would otherwise be wasting ammo on. Not to mention, this thing has 18 rounds per magazine, which is awesome. You know, because the Colt's great and all. It does a lot more damage, but the problem is it only has 5 rounds. And if I'm in a room full of enemies, this is actually, in some cases, better, really, just because I don't have to reload it after 5 shots. You know. And let's be honest, a shot in someone's head with this is going to kill them just as dead as a shot in someone's head with this. Provided they're not wearing a helmet of some sort, so, you know. The Enfield kind of goes without saying. That's pretty much becoming my signature weapon, I think. I can't imagine ever replacing this lovely, lovely thing, frankly. Maybe with an actual sniper rifle, but even then I don't need a sniper rifle because this thing comes with a scope, which I can attach whenever I damn well please. And I got the shotgun because, even though I'm not as big a fan of the lever action as I am the pump action was in shitty condition and it was worth lots of money, so I sold it. And I've kept this because I already have lots of 20 gauge ammo, so I don't expect to be using this very often, frankly, but it's good to have a shotgun around. So, yeah. There we go. I gave the cowboy hats I found some thought and decided against it. It's not that I've got anything specifically against them, it's just I'm not really feeling the kind of cowboy look. I've played lots of characters in the past that did the whole cowboy thing. In fact, the last character I really got stuck into this game with had the sort of cowboy thing going on. And this time I'm thinking, no, not really. Especially when I put on the rattan cowboy hat, it sort of, you know, it went from this gentleman explorer sort of a look to a sort of cattle rancher type guy look. It's just, it transformed the moustache in every possible way. So I've decided against it. I will give some more thought to picking up a helmet if I ever come across one, but yeah. I wouldn't bank on it. What I really need, I think, it probably is some sort of combat armor, honestly. And at some point in the distant future, some power armor as well. This is going to be it. This is definitely going to be one of those characters you use power armor with, I think. I can just imagine him wading into a bunch of powder gangers and smashing them to bits with a power fist or you know, just laying waste to them all with a Gatling laser. That would be awesome. So, yeah. Big fan of the old advanced technologies, Sir David Crumpington. He likes style as well, obviously, but in his honest opinion, highly advanced technology has a style all of its own. So, that's what I'm going with anyway. I'm liking the classic Fallout look. I'm liking the leather armor with the matching leather backpack. It's looking good. It's growing on me. I'm fine with that. I don't need to add a hat. We can do just fine without anyway. Now the long slog back to Prim. And here we are. Hello again, Prim. Or the outskirts of Prim, or whatever. I'm not entirely sure where Prim stops and this rubble begins. Not that it really matters much. There's nothing else for us to do really here in Prim. We've got all the info we needed. We need to find a sheriff for this place, if for no other reason, then so Steve can proceed with our little casino get-rich-quick scheme. But in the meantime, we do need to see a gentleman named Randall. Let's see. Blueprints, they went that away. Yeah, we gotta get to Novak, so speak with Randall about the bounty hunter position, and that is just over there. So unfortunately, I think we're a little bit fenced in here. I don't know if... Aha! Thank God for that. I didn't want to have to go all the way around again and then out that way and all that kind of nonsense. Would suck. I want to get this out. Actually, we're going into uncharted territory here. After all, campfire. And lad's life. Yeah, well, it's worth checking. That marker added. Really? The Pip-Boy has received a signal telling you to continue up this pass. Does it? Doesn't seem to have. I'm curious. What's in here? Oh, it must have been a prison lorry of some description. Oh, nothing terribly useful here. Oh, crates. Oh! He says, finding a cache of fucking frag grenades. Damn! Not bad. Not bad at all. Oh, hello. There we go, got him in the end. The most accurate weapon this, but I've got plenty of ammo to spare, so it doesn't really matter. Ooh, hello, what have we got here? Ah! NCR Trooper. It's with some Radaway, nice. And a dog tag. On a bit. Hmm, not bad. Sorry, old chap. I think you were probably long dead, though. Not much I could have done. Oh. I rarely seem to actually hit anything on the first shot. Hmm. Oh, God. Bloody well camouflaged, aren't you? Fair play to you, nature. You had me fooled there for a second. Lonesome Road, Courier 6. Can go home, it's DLC. It's DLC. I think we'll leave that alone for now. graves. Do we want to dig those up? No one will ever know. Well then, anyway, we'll check that out at a later date, shall we? Looks dangerous to me, and we've got better things to be doing right now than indulging in idle curiosity. Although, obviously, indulging in idle curiosity is something of a pastime of mine, however, we do actually have things to do for once. So, let's do them. This must be the place. Oh! You know, part of me just feels pretty bad about murdering hordes of innocent coyotes, but well, you know, they're just going to attack you otherwise, aren't they? It's not my fault they decided to make a little nest 5 feet away from Randall's house. Thing. Shack. Whatever you want to call it. Hello! I am Sir David Crumpington, Esquire, and this is, Bertie. Hey there. How do you do?
Hello. Welcome to Randall and Associates. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Stephen Randall, owner and operator. I assume you're here for the position, correct?
Yes, I am, if it's still open, of course.
Hell yes, it's open. I can begin the interview if you're ready. I only have one question. Are you willing to kill people for money? Yes or no?
Absolutely.
That's good, but I need to be up front with you. You'll be pursuing high-risk bounties. Many of the targets are extremely dangerous. But with the high stakes comes increased rewards. There's cash for every bounty, an increased payment as you complete more contracts. There's quick money in bounties, but you can rapidly make a name for yourself, and a lot of people will be looking for payback. So, what's your decision? Are you still ready to pursue the bounties?
Well, I've made enough enemies already in the last few days I've been here, so... What's a few more? Why not?
Your first target is Tom Quigley, a former NCR Ranger who's rumored to be the best marksman in the Mojave. Apparently he contracted syphilis and steadily lost his fucking mind. Despite his abilities with a rifle, he was drummed out of the Rangers. He eventually turned to banditry and murder, taking great pleasure in sniping Brahmin caravans from afar. Quigley's crazy, but he's still damn lethal. He's usually camped out in the hills west of the old Poseidon gas station. Any questions?
How did you get started as a bounty hunter? Now, I let's make a good impression. Let's not mess around. I'm ready.
Good. Bring back Quigley's trigger finger as proof, and you'll get the bounty. Just don't get killed out there.
Bring back his finger? His finger? Oh, for fingerprints, I assume. Ah, that would explain everything. Come on, then. But we've got a incredibly dangerous NCR sniper with syphilis to kill. This might not have been the best idea I've ever had.